I think this is a glorious day because we're going to focus a lot on the what and the how. And what I was asked to talk about is why. Why do we care about the what and the how? And I'm a booster, the Reader, if any of you ever read that news magazine that comes out weekly, has on more than one occasion called me UCSD's chief booster. I was a cheerleader in high school, okay? I confess. But I think it's important to remember that we're working for an institution on whom not only our city, but our state, and you could argue our country depends. The kinds of work that is being done in the 21st century in research universities like UC San Diego is critical to economic competitiveness, to human and social well-being, and to quality of life in terms of the joy people have in their lives. And we all know, in the age of science and knowledge, the building blocks of all the companies of the future are going to come from the science and technology coming from institutions like ours. The talent pool of the future, even if they aren't college grads, are going to need to be digitally literate, are going to have skills that are integrated with the kind of teaching and work that we do. So I once wrote a book about 20 years ago called Knowledge Without Boundaries. And I think that speaks to the why, because knowledge is the critical resource in society today. And that's the business we're in. We're a knowledge enterprise. And we do it in three ways. The first, of course, is research. That the whether we're talking about medicine, whether we're talking about environmental technologies, health, how we do our work, how hotels book and serve their clients, how retail operates, it's all being affected by the kind of research that is coming out of places like UC San Diego. I think the second piece that is so critical is talent. Our education across the lifespan, which includes us folks in University Extension with our 66,000 enrollments, you'd be interested to know that 80% of those are college grads. They're not looking for their first degree or their first credential. They live in a world where the science and technology that's happening here transforms the content of work, transforms the way businesses do their business locally and globally. And so they come back to us. They come back to the university across the lifespan. So we're an asset not only to those extraordinary 39,000 this year, undergraduate, graduate, and medical students who are resident on our campus, but another 35,000 plus who are in this region and in this state who are trying to get access to the skills and the knowledge they need to be just to be effective in their everyday work. And I think there's a third dimension, which is community. And I don't know how many of you are in the arts and humanities, but I can tell you, in the extension world, lectures on books, concerts, introduction to Latino jazz, all kinds of culturally and humanistically enriching experiences come from this university. And they also reflect the growing diversity of the community in which we live. And so to do all of this, to be this kind of research force, this talent development force, and this lifelong community resource across arts, culture, humanities, civic education, requires us. And that, to me, is why we're all here today. Our community, our state, our country need us. I should have been a preacher, right? And I think it's important to remember that. That's why we're here. Thank you.